Hello guys, welcome to CR&T Designers, Chetan here. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to make a hat in Blender 2.9 and its plus version. So this hat is the combination of magician hat, ghost hat and sci-fi hat. In the first part, we are going to learn how to model it. In the second part, we are going to learn how to UV unwrap it and texture it. So before moving toward the hat, if you didn't subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe it. And are you ready for it? So let's get started. To create a hat, we need to add a cylinder. Add a cylinder, bring it top, then go to edit mode, delete its bottom face, then scale it down its top face like this, and then add two loop cuts, one will be the bottom and another will be the top. Okay, now next, shear smooth and add a bevel modifier, 0.00 will be the amount and change it to the angle. Now the next thing, take a knife tool and create a slant cut. Click Z, press Z and then click and then enter. Then you will be get such kind of cut. Next thing, select those cut, means select those edges and then add a bevel like this. After adding the bevel, select those bevel faces. Then you need to take this extrude inside those bevel faces, then you will get such kind of result. After finally, add a subdivision surface modifier for good shading and then select the top face and insert it. Here you can see our main part of the hat is ready. Now go to the edit mode, select the bottom edge of the hat and scale it, extrude it and bring it down. Now go to the top view and extrude it and scale to the X and Y axis. Okay, now adjust its scale and go to the side view. I want a curved shape, so that's why select the vertices of the side view and every time deselect few vertices from the both side and try to achieve that curved shape. Okay, so this is a very pretty simple step to achieve that curvedness in the hat. Okay, you can see the curvedness in the hat. Now select that bottom edge which is the middle and then add a bevel on it and increase its segment something around the 5, that will work much more better. Now next thing, it is select that outer edge and extrude it and scale it little bit and take it little bit up. There you go. Now next thing is to add the solidify modifier. Add a solidify modifier. Make sure that solidify modifier at the top of the other two modifiers and increase its thickness. Then you will get this result, which is pretty cool. Now the basic part and important part of the hat is ready, right there. Now we need to create a belt. How to create a belt? Select the faces and Shift D and duplicate these faces and then press P and selection. Okay. Now you have now you got the belt. How to that set the belt? It's very easy. You don't need to set up this belt. Now we are going to create a buckle. How to create a buckle? Add a cube and then scale it down and try to achieve the proper shape of the buckle. Simple. Now go to the edit mode and I have tried the another method but it won't work. So just select its top and bottom face. I will show you. Select its top and bottom face and then delete those faces. Like this. No. This is so, select the top and bottom face and insert it and delete that face. Okay, there you go. And select this vertices and press F to fill those gaps. After filling those gaps, you will get this. Now add a loop cut on it. Before going to add the bevel modifier and subdivision modifier, but subdivision modifier not work pretty. So you just leave on the bevel modifier. Okay, don't need to add the subdivision surface modifier. Okay, now the next thing, to create the main middle part of the buckle, add a loop cuts. Two loop cuts are fine. Okay, now select those faces and delete those faces. Okay, from the top and the bottom. Now select the vertices and create the face right there and create that cube. Fill those gaps like this. Press F for it. Okay, now our buckle is ready. Now shear smooth and auto normal, auto smooth. Then try to give the proper position to your buckle, which is very important. Okay, as like this. Now select to your belt and take the little bit part of your belt outside that buckle, as we can see in the real life. Okay, we are going to do the same thing. Now select that edge and you can add a bevel to get the more segment, so you can fix that buckle's little bit part outside of the buckle of your belt part. Okay, like this, and try to achieve the proper position of your belt and buckle. Now the next thing, we are going to make a pendulum. To create a pendulum, we need to add the circle. So please add a circle and go to the edit mode, select its all vertices and then extrude it inside. Then one more time extrude this inside like this and try to create the steps. Okay, extrude it and then extrude inside, scale it down like this. Then try to create a three step like this, same. Okay, now next thing, we need to add a UV sphere. So we want to create the crystal, and you can say the ball in that pendulum, which is marble like. So add a UV sphere, rotate it into 90 degrees, and then scale it down like this, and try to fix the right position of your UV sphere at the center of the pendulum, which we have pendulum mesh which we have created. Okay, right now we need to we don't need that backside of this UV sphere. So for that, just go to the edit mode and delete its backside. So select the vertices and Control X for dissolve those vertices. Okay, right now the next thing, select your UV mesh and then symmetrize it, so you will get the backside of your pendulum mesh. Okay, right now, select the vertices and try to make it plane. Okay, Alt N for recalculate the normal, and then recalculate the normal so you will get the better shading. Then shade smooth, add a bevel modifier and subdivision surface modifier, which will give you smooth shading. So this is a simple thing which we need to do while creating any object. Now select everything, and now I'm going to create a little bit design on this pendulum. So select the faces like this, and you can try your own design. So if you are going to try your own design, then that will be much more better. So select the faces and try to extrude it inside like this, so you will get little bit fancy pendulum. Okay, so it's totally in your hand how to create, how to stylize your pendulum. Okay, right now the next thing, I'm going to add a loop cuts like there. Add a three loop cuts, select those loop cuts and bevel on it, and then extrude these faces inside, so you will get a little bit more design. Okay, like this. Now I'm going to add one more loop cut on the next faces. Okay, now add a one more loop cut right there. I'm going to insert that face. So after inserting that face, then scale it, extrude it outside. Just select and unselect that individual, so you would get the complete selection. Okay, then extrude it outside, so your pendulum is now ready and it's look pretty well. Now we need to do the proper position for this pendulum. So Shift S and selection to the cursor, so you will get at the center. Your pendulum will be at the center of the origin. Now next thing is, you need to parent your pendulum ball to the pendulum mesh like this, and then there you go, you can fix your pendulum at the right position at the center of your hat. Now our hat is ready, and we are going to UV unwrap this hat. Select that hat and go to the UV unwrapping tab, UV editing. But we don't need to UV unwrap this hat because it is already UV unwrapped, because it is, I have created this hat with the cylinder. Okay, then belt is also already UV unwrapped. We just need to UV unwrap our pendulum. So select its outer edge, top edge and bottom edge, and then Control E, mark seam those edges, those two edges, and then UV unwrap like this. Now we have successfully UV unwrapped our pendulum, and now we are going to do the next part, which is the shading, and which is very interesting. So click on the shading tab and just go for the shading. So click on the shade tab and go for the shading. Now I'm going to create a new texture, and that will be the hat black texture. Okay, black cloth texture. So I will create cloth texture, decrease its roughness little bit, and increase the sheen completely. Add a little bit very small subsurface scattering. Add your cloth texture and connect it to the base color, and add a mix RGB and drop it into the base color or texture. And I'm going to create a black color texture. for this cloth, hat cloth. So that's why I have added the mix RGB, and so I can add the black color. Okay, now add your normal maps and the bump maps and connect those at the right position. Okay, so you will get the better texture and which will give the more realism to your object. And it's look pretty well. So add a little bit of surface cutting, very less, that will give you the cool effect. Now try to adjust the strength of your normal map. Okay, now I'm going to create the next texture, which is for the belt. Okay, now to create a belt texture, create a new texture. I'm going to create this texture with the texture which is the Warnock texture. Okay, so add a Warnock texture and Control T. If your node triangular add-on is turned on, then you will get the mapping and texture coordinate node. Then you connect your UV to the vector. Add a mix RGB and put that mix RGB into the Warnock texture. Okay, so I have taken the red color because for my convenience. Then I will change that color. Okay, I will use the black and brown color. Then connect that the mix RGB node output to the bump node and connect that bump node to the normal. So you will get little bit bumpness on this your belt, and which will give the more realistic effect. So our belt is also ready. Now the next thing, to create a texture for the buckle. I want a gold buckle, so I'm going to create the texture which will be like a gold texture for this buckle and simple metal texture. Add a mix RGB to create that buckle texture. Increase its metallic and decrease its roughness and add a mix RGB. Okay, and try to give the proper color, proper gold color. So that's why I have said you that add two colors, so mix those two colors together to achieve that the gold color. Simple. Okay, like this, and give that same color, same texture material to your pendulum also. Now I'm going to create the texture for this glass ball. So add a mix shader, connect that and transparent BSDF, and connect the mix principal BSDF and transparent BSDF to the mix shader. Then add one more mix shader, and right now just add one more and add a emission shader and connect that emission shader to the mix shader. And to create the two colors, I'm going to add mix RGB and noise texture, and I'm going to add the mix RGB also. So I add a mix RGB and give two colors, and those connect that output to the emission shader. So you will get the noise texture right there with the two colors simply. And here you can see I have created the beautiful texture for this glass ball, you can see. And just increase its transmission little bit and decrease its roughness little bit, so you will get the proper texture for your glass ball, which is like a marble. And then give the proper texture to your metal mesh of your pendulum. Now our hat is looking pretty well. I have added one HDRI for good light condition. I have downloaded the HDRI font, HDRI Heaven. So you can download it and add any HDRI, and just create a studio light setup for this product shoot. So if you didn't watch my product shoot tutorial, how to do studio light setup for the product shoot, then please watch that tutorial. I will give the link of that tutorial in the description. Create a studio light setup, and in this tutorial I am going to give, for this product I am going to use the only one light, which is the key light, and I will use another light which is the background light, means environment light. So I will go with the only one light, which will be the key lights. Then add a use the composition guides and fix your camera position. And now add a key light which is already at there, and that will be the area light. And your key light should be at the above of your subject, and it should be in the 45 degree angle. Then increase its strength, add one more plane, and that plane will work as a diffusion, means soft box, and because we want a soft light, not a hard light. Okay, so give it another material, that will be in that material you just need to increase the transmission and subsurface scattering for this softbox, which will give you the proper texture of the softbox, proper material for the softbox. Now your lighting setup is also ready, and just you need to take render with the cycle render, increase changes high contrast color management, and there you go, you are ready to take a render. And here our hat is looking pretty well awesome.
If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. And thanks for watching this tutorial. Stay with us and see you in the next video. Bye bye.